Damn it, Illumination! Stop trying to distract me from the 48 seconds of logos by dressing them up with your tiny little cash cows. Either these giraffes are freakishly short, or the animators left them in the anthropomorphizer longer than they were supposed to so they could fit into this human-sized building. Once there was a way. Damn it, this movie is about singing animals, but immediately misses the chance to have an actual beetle singing a Beatles song.
This was it.
Koala Bearation.
Some folks may have said he grew up to be the greatest showman the city has ever seen.
Well, since there's just the one theater in town that he owns, doesn't seem like the competition is too stiff, right? Why the hell would a koala with koala-sized legs ride a normal-sized bicycle, even if the pedals are retrofitted? All the land mammals seem to get preferential treatment in the anthropomorphizing process. They all get to stand on their hind legs and have mostly human bodies, but this poor whale has to basically just be a whale with a hat. Jeez, it's like some suit at Illumination saw Zootopia and said, "Give me that, except more animal variety and less plot." Oh, and no f***ing Shakira. Also, the fact that these fish have to commute to work through what looks like a sewer further solidifies my guess that this city puts water-dwelling creatures at a systematic disadvantage. Go, go, go! Getaway car is conveniently and magically parked here, since there was no car in this alley when Johnny was waiting for them to make a break for it. Johnny is able to run and catch up to a speeding pickup truck.
You were supposed to be keeping a lookout!
But he did. As soon as he saw the cops, he said,
"Guys, listen, stay where you are!"
Movie decides to introduce all its key characters by aggressively flinging the audience around town. Real world pigs have about 10 pigs per litter on average, so nature has clearly been a dick to Rosita. How are these porcupines even wearing shirts? Do they have to put their shirts on like Snuggies and then fasten them to their quills?
Happy birthday, dear Grandpa!
No one likes a person that oversings the happy birthday song. You either shout it off key or you don't sing it at all, Tori Kellefant. Those are the rules.
Empty your pockets right now! Aha! I knew it! Y'all saw it right here, the monkey lied!
Everyone seems much more worried about the monkey lying to the mouse than the mouse literally mugging the monkey. Since this audience couldn't be expected to know more than one jazz song, Mike goes from playing Dave Brubeck to Jerry Rafferty. Do the kids today like Jerry Rafferty? I'm not familiar with Animal Time, but are they approximating human life here? Rosita's making the kids breakfast, which means it's sometime in the morning. Johnny and his family are robbing a bank in the morning, which at least makes some sense. I'd even believe Mina's grandfather was having a birthday party in the early AM because he's old and sh**. But there's no way a fancy-ass restaurant like this is open and hopping this early. I hope Mrs. Crawley just bought that fan, set it up at her desk, and just turned it on for the first time right before this moment. Because if not, then why would she regularly use a fan powerful enough to screw with her face and pop out her fake eye? Fan that fans this f***ing plot isn't fanning at all when the perspective isn't on Mrs. Crawley. And that's some fantastic bullshit.
Gonna need more than that. Just a second. $1,000!
No wonder Buster's Theater is failing. At least Max Bialystock had the wherewithal to screw some old ladies for money. Maybe try that. Miss Crawley is literally looking directly at the mischievous fake eye that's adding to the award total, yet does nothing to change the amount, because plot. Also, do the screenwriters think no one would compete in a competition for just $1,000? That's a lot of goddamn money.
Miss Crawley, no, no!
Motherfucker! 90% of this movie's initial story is fan-based.
I guess that's one way to spread the word.
This is apparently an incredibly windy day in the city, but the leaves on the trees are barely moving. A flyer manages to get to every character that was forcibly introduced earlier in the film. If you're an animal society, why would you even manufacture human-style headphones? Shouldn't Beats by Dre be releasing species-specific sets? Even though Buster bangs his head on the top of his desk drawer right when he gets up, he suddenly has enough room to sit upright while he puts on his suit.
I need you some coffee. Oh, I got a little thirsty on the way up those stairs.
And nothing's more thirst-quenching than a piping hot cup of coffee.
Get your scaly tail downstairs and throw those doors open wide!
To do what? They can't have a staff that can operate the singing auditions because they've been screwed in previous shows. If they show back up for this sh**, their union is butt. I know Illumination is big, but they either budgeted the entire $75 million of their budget for the rights to these songs, or someone has something on Beyonce, who of course runs music. Also, did these shrimp have a handler, or did they push their tank all the way here by swimming and hitting the front end of the fishbowl over and over? Frogs audition with Jump because nuance is for suckers. This movie answers the question no one asked. What if there was a movie that was Zootopia meets Glee meets Pitch Perfect?
Oh my gosh. Look at her butt.
Sure, this movie with a paper-thin plot is almost 2 hours long, so there's definitely some time to devote to animated rabbits dancing to a song about penis.
Just going out.
Well, don't be long. I've got a gag coming over.
If this movie was more interesting, I'd wonder why the gorillas have Cockney accents and sound like they stepped out of a Guy Ritchie film. Also, you just perpetrated a large robbery this morning. Shouldn't you be, like, counting bills or stashing your loot somewhere? Is this the most appropriate time for a workout? Run like the microphone is able to clearly pick up the snail's voice, even though he is sitting on top of it. I'm becoming more and more convinced that Garth Jennings, the writer of this f***ing ridiculousness, went on a long road trip, kept switching the stations on his radio, and then said, "Let's film this."
All right, enough of that. That's quite enough of that. That's it. Come on. Off the stage, Helga. Go on, you're useless.
Jesus Christ, why didn't they just go ahead and make the Seth MacFarlane character a f***ing teddy bear?
Pennies from heaven.
You really have to hand it to this microphone. You can sing into it backwards, and it still manages to sound like a recording from a studio.
'Cause baby, you're a firework.
Wait, Rosita left the house long after the auditions began, so she should be at the end of the massive line, but there's still a ton of people left on the sidewalk.
Please.
Wait, they're still here? The line was all the way down the block. Has everyone been packed like sardines backstage in the green room? I hope the fire marshal isn't auditioning. Waiting 20 minutes before lazily throwing in a fart joke shows restraint, and I'd like to give you points for trying, movie, but we don't award points here. We do sins, so... Snail helm scream.
Oh, whoopsie.
God damn it, are we just making up for lost time now?
Daniel, you're in the show!
What? Are you talking to me?
F*** you, movie. If you're gonna play with scale like this, do it consistently. It'd be much more entertaining than this bullshit. Also, since all the other giraffes we've seen are small enough to comfortably fit through doors, this giraffe has probably gone through life thinking he's freakishly tall, when in fact, he's the most anatomically correct giraffe in town.
Is Rosita still here?
Oh, yes. Yes, I'm here.
And I've abandoned my 25 children to stay here all day until the final decision was made.
I could partner you up with Gunther.
Are we sure there isn't a second kind of pixist reason Buster wants to partner Rosita and Gunter?
You are my chosen few.
Yeah, but why? He's only chosen 5 acts out of all those auditions, and many of them were good. Couldn't you make even more money with a bigger cast?
No, this is no show.
Illumination continues the long animated tradition of reductive cultural stereotypes.
I don't know, maybe we could do something together.
Like properly fund and produce a singing competition? High schools do it all the time.
Because it belonged to my father. Every day for 30 years, he worked his tail off washing cars just so I could buy this place.
Buster's dad worked a minimum wage job his whole life so his son could buy a theater, because Buster's dad had no expenses and died 30 minutes after retiring. This house for elephants has doorways that aren't even close to elephant-sized.
If I won that money, we could build our own recording studio, start our own label, I mean...
Don't get me wrong, $100K is a lot of money, but that's more like a down payment on a working recording studio and a record label, unless this town has the same inflation rate as America in the 1950s. Saxophone playing mouse somehow makes it into a singing competition that isn't saxophone based. You know, it's a lot easier to woo a mouse girl if you've got backing tracks.
So when exactly is this ship coming in then?
Hopefully around the time someone explains to me why this singing movie has a heist in the middle of it. Is it because the concept of an animal jukebox musical about a singing competition is kind of boring on its own?
You make the best pie, honey.
Listen, movie, I don't care how lazy you are, I'm not overlooking that this is not f***ing pie.
Now I want you all dressed before breakfast.
Rosita made this entire contraption with a drill and a toy train.
Oh, I found him. Bye, honey.
Bye, Norman.
Movie has Rosita create this ridiculous device overnight, driving home the joke that none of the other 26 pigs in her family notices whether she's actually present, and that's depressing as f***.
Now you only get one shot.
Before writing this monologue, the screenwriter said, "How close can I get to lose yourself without forcing the movie studio to spend any more licensing money?"
There. Ah. Isn't this a great color for you?
Movie suggests skimpy outfits will enhance a porcupine's sex appeal on stage, and I'm already out of f**ks to give to movie. There's enough visible slack on this black power cord to easily plug these two cables in, but here it's suddenly too tight to connect.
Yay! It's about time!
Buster connects one extension cord and the entire theater's power comes back on, proving no one working on this movie has ever electriced. This small art house theater contains an epically large backstage with multiple dance studios and rehearsal spaces. Despite all the money they spent on securing the rights to all this music in this movie, they use the same Dave Brubeck song twice. Still unclear on why the vehicles are human-sized, even though there's a massive disparity between the proportion of all these different species. The horror film industry has overused jump scares so much they're starting to show up in kids' movies. You know, if she had the capacity to make this device all along, why didn't she do it sooner? Also, maybe she should abandon the singing competition and find an engineering competition, because constructing a system that automates all the housework is way more impressive than singing Katy Perry's Firework.
Anyone seen my glass eye?
Buster doesn't notice there's a glass eye the size of a cue ball in his coffee, nor does he notice that this large glass eye ended up in his mouth.
Anata dashi.
Buster just happens to have an English to Japanese translation book on him.
But here's my number, so call me maybe.
Movie reaches hard for that sweet, sweet 2012 nostalgia.
I want love to change my friends to enemies.
God damn it, movie. You can have all the Carly Rae Jepsens and Nicki Minajs in the world, but do not get Jack White involved in this.
Well, you're one great card player, Mike.
Oddly, this Sing movie just got a little rounders in it. Another small, insignificant difference between this animal world and our world is manhole, animal hole covers are apparently extremely lightweight.
Got to show the fire on desire!
The fire went out a long time ago.
Rosita's apparently going through early onset swinepause. Also, if the fire went out, then how the hell does she have so many small kids? Can't have been out for that long.
Let the music take control of your body parts.
My body parts are not responding, okay? It's never gonna happen.
Instead of writing one cohesive and interesting story and placing the popular music of the day around that, movie decides to take a reverse approach. Mash a bunch of pop songs being sung by animals together, then pepper in small, predictable conflicts that pop up like whack-a-mole throughout the movie.
Set for life now, boys! What's going on?
Hang on. The plan was that the ship was
gonna dock at night, right here.
And that's when they were gonna break in and steal the gold. But now it's broad f***ing daylight. These gorillas deserve to be caught if they're gonna plan this haphazardly. Also, these assholes are remarkably clean for just emerging from the sewer. Movie paid to use true colors, but forgot to include it in the story, so they just threw it into the shop and dance scene for a few seconds. Jesus, theft must be a huge problem at this grocery store to justify this sophisticated camera system and full-time security guard to monitor it. Buster didn't worry about putting contact information on this flyer. Does everyone just know who Miss Crawley is?
Rosita, have you seen my card?
Of all the ways this hilariously complicated system could be screwed up, all it takes is a tiny misplaced f***ing beach ball. The only way Johnny could get this good at piano this quickly is if he were actually Phil Connors, and it's living the same day over and over again.
And Mina, last chance kid, you wanna join these guys out there today?
I just get so scared.
But he hasn't even heard her sing. Did he forget about the massive line of people around the block that showed up to audition for this show? Why can't he call one of those people to be in the show?
Mr. Moon, she's here!
Miss Crawley is the slowest moving animal in this movie, yet she's somehow able to get from a window to see Nana's car pull up and run to warn everyone that she's here before the car has enough time to park in front of the building.
Boss, that's his car, isn't it? Pull over.
Man, that criminal underbelly of this animated town is f***ing vast.
That's all there is? He lied. Moon lied to us all!
Wait a second, I can explain.
He's your problem,
okay?
It's not me.
Even though Moon is correctly being called out for lying, everyone ignores the blatant armed robbery that's occurring right in front of them. Talk about bearing the lead.
Nana! I'm so sorry,
Nana and Eddie were somehow able to get out of the theater without even getting a little wet. The theater is the only structure that's demolished, even though it's attached on both sides to non-demolished buildings. Movie expects us to believe that this fits inside this.
Oh, Dad. I'm so sorry.
Contrived koala carelessly cries, casually clutching cup.
Oh my gosh!
Movie yada yada's over the fact that Rosita almost killed her entire family.
It is a miracle anyone survived this unbelievable disaster.
Reporter Dog would be excellent at CinemaSins. Not only is this humiliating, it's a horribly inefficient way to wash a car. Also, even though there are very few differences between this animal world and our human world, it is somehow acceptable that Buster and Eddie use their bodies to clean people's cars instead of sponges and towels.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Man, will people ever stop covering pentatonic songs? This montage is brought to you by Exposition Witness News, EWN. We tell you what's going on so your movie doesn't have to.
The name Buster Moon will go down in entertainment history once and for all, as he and this bunch of bumbling amateurs attempt to restage the show that brought down his theater.
How the f*** does this news reporter know the performers are bumbling amateurs? No one's seen the show, and everyone was super f***ing excited about it before the theater collapsed. So are they still running the power from that one extension cord from next door?
We're putting on a show here. You all should come and see it.
Ironically, this was how this movie was pitched to the head of Illumination at the bar at the local Applebee's, and unfortunately he was drunk enough to say yes.
Here we go.
Welcome to me!
Buster clearly started facing the right way when he started descending, so how the f*** did he get turned around on the way down without noticing? Johnny's piano sounds fantastic, even though it was completely submerged in water a few days ago and is currently being tied together with bungee cords.
Johnny?
Don't you know I'm still standing?
Holy s***, not only does this prison have TV, they've got it right in the cell! I mean, it's not 25 million in gold, but this ain't a bad setup. News cameras are able to get multiple angles of the concert they were mockingly covering live a few minutes ago. This is pretty much the only time we see animals animaling, right? Wouldn't it have been much more interesting to see the gorillas robbing the bank using gorilla moves instead of driving away in regular-ass getaway cars? By breaking out of jail and running to see his son's concert, Big Daddy completely misses his son's concert.
You are all trespassing on private property, what? And you will leave right now.
Why is the bank only finding out about this now? Buster and his pals did some pretty extensive work on this property before putting on this show, and no one from the bank found out about it? Easy, camera. It's only the porcupine version of Scarlett Johansson.
I'm so proud of you.
Even though I disowned you after you got me arrested because you were rehearsing for a talent show, you were on TV for a second, so bygones. Why the ever-loving f*** is Mike being blown up by the helicopters here? Shouldn't he be getting flattened by the rotor wind?
Sing.
Roll credits. Seriously, can we f***ing roll credits yet? This movie's at least 20 minutes longer than it should be. Man, it would be super f***ing annoying to be standing behind these giraffes. Shouldn't they be required to sit in the back? Look, I know they needed to let Tori Kelly get her moment here, since she's the only real singer in the cast, but this song's legitimately terrible. This is your closer? Bring out Johnny to do some more Elton John. That was dope. Yeah, you're probably thinking there's no way they could make a movie about animated shiny squids, right?
Illumination.
Stop that. You're not going into a song while I'm here.
That's what I love about these high school girls, man. I get older, they stay the same age.
Well, you're one great card player, Mike.
Pay him. Pay that man his money.
A cake's no good if you don't mix the batter and bake it.
Raised lettering. Pale nimbus.
Look at that subtle off-white coloring. Oh my god. It even has a watermark.
I guess you guys aren't ready for that yet.
Contest is war. This stage is the battlefield. Your song is your weapon.
I'm taking home cold hard cash, motherfucker.
What's going on here?
Hi, I'm Becky.
You better call Becky with the good hair.
Rain came down in rushing, rising rivulets, till the river crept out of its bed and crept right into piglets.